what happens with cancer? Well, what's really important to understand is that the fundamental thing that all cells do, whether it's a cell in a multicellular organism like us, or it's a bacteria, or a protozoa, or anything, a fungus, a single-celled organism, the fundamental thing that a cell must do is make energy. It takes in something from the environment, and whatever it is, even plants. The plant takes in what? Takes in carbon dioxide from the air, takes in the sunlight for the energy, and it produces stuff. So the organism has to take something in, convert that into energy, and then use that energy for its metabolic functions. Okay, that's what being alive is. And when you can no longer take in energy and utilize it, you're dead. Okay, so it's the fundamental thing. So every cell in our body is taking in glucose and oxygen and other things, and it goes into these little organelles called mitochondria. And the mitochondria are the energy producers. They take that sunlight, the oxygen, and they take the glucose, and they perform magic. They perform alchemy. They turn it into what's called ATP, adenosine triphosphate, which is the currency of energy. So every cell, every enzyme that needs energy grabs ATPs and removes that final phosphate and has free energy. So that's where energy comes from. So the ATPs carry it around. Well, with a healthy cell, a normally functioning cell, those mitochondria will take one glucose molecule, six oxygens, and that one glucose molecule becomes 38 ATPs. That's pretty good yield, 38 from one. Now, what happens is we live a life that we're being exposed to EMF, we're being exposed to now 5G, or the water we're drinking has got chemicals in it. The air we're breathing is not clean. The clothing we're wearing is not organic. We're absorbing things through our skin. Our food is not organic, and it's got heavy metals, and it's got pesticides and herbicides and fungicides and all of that sort of thing. So, and then we're stressed. We're late for appointments. We can't get this project done on time, or we had a fight with our boyfriend or girlfriend, whatever. So all of these things combine and conspire to damage cells. Okay, now the part of the cell that's the most vulnerable is the mitochondria, because it's got oxygen in there, and oxygen is flammable on a biochemical level. It's flammable. In other words, it produces free radicals and stuff. So the most vulnerable organelles in the cell are the mitochondria. So when enough of them, 35-40% of them, become inactivated, the cell must go and use another mode of energy production. Because remember, energy is the fundamental thing a cell must make. If it doesn't have the energy, it can't even hold its shape. It's got these sodium potassium pumps, and it's got other kinds of pumps and pores and all that sort of thing. It takes energy to maintain that, so it can't even hold its shape. So the fundamental thing a cell must do is make energy. So once that ability to make energy is diminished, the mitochondria start to, the cell has to adapt, and that adaptation is to start fermenting. Okay, now once the cell, if those mitochondria are gone and the cell cannot go back to using the mitochondria, it's kind of stuck fermenting. That's cancer.